Hi, Matt with Custom Car Grills here with an install video for the 2013-14 Cadillac ATS. The first order of business is to unclip the chrome molding. There's a handful of these clips along the top edge, and then there's two on each of the sides. With the clips released, the chrome molding should be easily removable and can be set off to the side for now. Next, there's quite a few plastic welds on the back of the grill that will need to be sanded off to remove the factory mesh. A Dremel equipped with a sanding drum will typically make short work of this. Any of the grits of the Dremel sanding drums should work for this, but I'm using a 60 grit drum, which usually goes a little bit faster than some of the others. With all of the plastic welds removed, the factory mesh should lift right out with ease. The emblem will also be readily accessible and come out easily. Then it's time to equip our Dremel with a number 543 cutting and shaping wheel. This will be used to cut out those horizontal bars in the center of the grill. I like to make the cuts close to the edge, but leave a little room so I can sand it smooth later on. After the cuts are made, the center section can be lifted out and discarded. Next, it's back to the sanding drum attachment to sand down the remaining portion of the bar that may still be there. This is just sanding to remove the bulk of the excess plastic. I'll smooth it out further in a moment. Here's a quick shot of the bars removed and the edge rough sanded. With the sanding drum still attached, now's a good time to sand down the remnants of the plastic welds along the bottom edge. Then I'm going to grab some 3/4 inch wide masking tape. This will be used to create a temporary barrier for some plastic weld material. It's usually best to use a mesh or fiber cloth in this area, but the chrome surround needs to snap back in, so the plastic weld can't be built up on the back as much as I would normally like. The plastic weld I'm using is Plyo Grip Plastic Repair number 3. Bondo, as well as other body fillers, can be used for this step. In general, I've had really good results with Plyo Grip in the past for similar projects, so I feel it's appropriate to use here. Once cured, the tape backing can be removed and discarded. Now I'm going to grab some 100 grit sandpaper. It's possible to sand by hand, like this, but I can usually make shorter work of it by sanding with the paper attached to a block sander, such as this one. I need to get this fairly smooth to the touch. Big gaps may need to be refilled before moving on. Next, I'll re-equip the cutting and shaping wheel to trim the back edge to a nice smooth line again. The edge looks good, but I still want to do a little bit more sanding. A small 3-inch sander running from an air compressor can be the best tool for the job here, but this can also be done by hand like in the previous steps. Not only am I sanding the inner edge, but the top edge had a couple nubs that remained from the bars, so I'm also sanding those down. To complete the repair, I'm using a finishing putty. A quick shake and a small amount squeezed out is all I need. Then add a little hardener and mix thoroughly and I'm ready to start. Icing the tight spots like this can be tricky or messy sometimes, but I'm doing the best I can before this starts to harden up. Once this is cured, then I'm going to go back to sanding again. This is the most important sanding of the project. It's crucial to get a nice smooth line on the top and inside edge. From here, we're going to paint the whole grill, including the chrome molding, gloss black. The foam tape along the top edge was already masked off, so I'm going to remove that backing now. Then I can snap back in place the previously chrome molding that we've now since painted black. Already, with just this simple change of the chrome to black molding, this is looking really good. Now onto the mesh piece that we have for sale on our website. This is pre-cut to account for all of the tabs and pre-bent to roughly the correct angles. If all the right cuts and preparation was done correctly, this mesh piece should drop right into the back of the grill opening like so. To temporarily hold the mesh in place, I'm going to use some foam and some cable ties. I'm simply placing some of the foam on the painted surface to protect it, and looping the tail end of the tie to the back of the mesh and firmly fastening it. It's important to note a couple things. First, I don't want to tie the ties too tight. Too much tension will distort the shape of the grill and make reinstallation difficult. Periodically pairing the grill next up to the bumper may be a good idea to make sure it hasn't changed shape. Another important thing to note is that I'm trying to keep the mesh symmetrical on both sides. There's a little give in the mesh, and if it's off balance just a little bit, then it'll show in the end result. A firm, but not overly tight tie, like this, is all that's needed to hold the mesh in place. With all the ties on, I'm going to snip the ends off. Then, a quick pass around the mesh to make sure all of the bend areas are making good contact with the edges on the back of the grill is advised. Since I had a lot of plyo grip left over, I'm going to use that to affix the mesh and grill frame together, but automotive goop is also a good alternative. While the plyo grip is designed to be a plastic repair filler, it also makes an excellent body panel adhesive. It's easy to apply and cures very quickly. The automotive goop is a great alternative because it's much cheaper and creates an excellent bond between mixed materials such as plastic and aluminum. The big downside with goop, though, is on a project like this, is the cure time. It's typically about a full day to cure compared to less than an hour with the plyo grip. Anyway, I'm spreading some of the excess plyo grip around with a toothpick to ensure some even coverage. With this starting to cure, I'm going to prep a new OEM all-black emblem to apply to this grill. There are some plastic tabs on the back that will need to be cut off with our Dremel cutting wheel. After the tabs are taken care of, I'm going to apply some 3M Redback foam tape to the back of the emblem. This will help keep it in place while I affix it to the mesh, as well as conceal any small gaps that may be between the mesh and the emblem. Once all of the Redback release tape has been removed, it's simply a matter of centering it up and sticking it on. To ensure it's really flush against the mesh, I'm going to also run one tie through the center of it to firmly hold it up against the mesh. Next, I'm going to use the remaining little plyo grip I have left to affix the emblem from behind the mesh. Now with everything all cured, I'm going to cut off the ties. They can be removed and discarded. This mesh installation is now complete, and wow, what a big difference this is. Our mesh mod is a lot of work, but the end result sure is worth it. There's a variety of ways the install can be done, including removing the emblem altogether and keeping the trim pieces chrome, such as this installed picture here. I look forward to checking out all the installs that come out of this, and I hope you liked this video. If you have any questions about this install or any of our others, feel free to contact me.